Hey everybody, David and David here from payitforward.com and upphone.com, and in this video we're going to talk about Cochlear and the Kanso 2 sound processor.
I'm a hearing person, David is a hearing person, and too often we take our connection to the world through sound for granted. Cochlear's new product, the Kanso 2 sound processor, is really a miracle of technology, because why shouldn't people expect the same innovations in their medical devices that they do in their other technology, like their iPhone or Android smartphone? And Cochlear has done an amazing job here bringing all these different technologies together.
The Kanso 2 sound processor is the first off-the-ear cochlear implant sound processor with direct smartphone connectivity. That means you can directly stream music, calls, or entertainment from the device. This sound processor was made with the latest and most advanced technology to help you experience clear sound, even in challenging environments. Its dual microphone and Smartsound IQ scan technology helps you focus on the sounds you want to hear, like conversations and music. We'd like to bring in Greg White. He is a cochlear implant recipient and is currently using the Kanso 2 sound processor.
He's also a cochlear employee because the Kanso 2 sound processor isn't even out yet, but he's been using it for several months now, and he's here to tell us all about it. Hi, Greg. Welcome. Would you tell us a little bit about your life before you got your first cochlear implant?
Sure. So long story short, my parents found out I had a hearing loss at 8 months old, and I had failed a newborn hearing screening, which was not standard at the time. Fast forward, after going and getting fitted with hearing aids but at that age, I went on to oral deaf school to learn how to hear and speak, which is hearing aids. And in 2003 or so, we really started looking more aggressively at cochlear implants because I was exhausted all the time, hearing aids, just my head constantly on a swivel, trying to read lips and keep up with the conversation. And, you know, my speech, as good as it was at the time, I still wasn't hearing those S sounds or T sounds. So I wasn't able to enunciate as well those words, for example, like stop. So fast forward, get the cochlear implant. And I remember driving home after the day we were activated, which is when they turned on the implant. And I pulled up to a stoplight with my mom, and I just hear this clicking sound. I'm like, Mom, what's that sound? She's like, that's a turn signal. You've never heard that before. You know, I get home, I walk inside, I hear the dogs running down the stairs with the dog tags jangling. Hadn't heard that before. Their nails clicking on the hardwood floors. Hadn't heard that either. So, as you can imagine, for how well I was doing my hearing aids before, the leap to make that decision to get a cochlear implant was absolutely life-changing. In a way, it made my life a little easier.
If a hearing aid is zero, you know, how far up the scale is a cochlear implant? What's the difference?
It's so different for every person. Let me just preface that. Everyone's experience with the cochlear implant is different. But the reality is, a hearing aid is trying to amplify sounds using a broken system. So like your ear's no longer working. Mm. What the cochlear implant is doing is basically bypassing the damaged parts of the ear and delivering sound directly to that hearing nerve. So with that in mind, it's really, I guess an analogy I'm thinking of is you're going from a world where you're watching TV in black and white to watching a TV that is in color, but in addition to it being in color, you also understand the world around you and what they're saying because you get the added benefit of subtitles, for example.
As a hearing person, not something I could really, I think, ever truly imagine what it must have been like to come from where you were to where you are today. But I think it is like a miracle of technology. So what we really want to touch on now, I think, is the Kanso 2 sound processor. Obviously, that wasn't your first sound processor because the Kanso 2 sound processor hasn't been released yet, right?
Yes, this is actually my seventh processor. I've been very fortunate to basically try or use every single one since I was first implanted. My previous generation sound processor, the Nucleus 7, has all the features of direct connectivity, rechargeable batteries, all of that. And what's really cool about the Kanso 2 is we've basically taken all those same great features and benefits and put it into one small package that can be worn off the ear.
What are your favorite features about the Kanso 2 processor?
My favorite features with the Kanso 2 sound processor is definitely the direct connectivity. being able to have a call with you guys right now, but hear it all directly from my processor. Listening to music directly to my processor, podcasts, and of course the ability to control my sound processor settings using my smartphone as well.
So are you an iPhone guy or an Android guy?
Personally, I'm an iPhone guy, but don't crucify me for it.
I won't. Well, we're iPhone guys too, but I understand that the Kanso 2 also works with Android phones. I know that there was a partnership, right, between Cochlear and Apple. How good is the integration with your iPhone?
Honestly, I've been very impressed by it. It's pretty seamless. Under your settings, I believe you guys even have it. There's a setting for hearing devices, and that's where you would go and pair your processor. So, you know, personally, I think Apple's done a really nice job of making sure they have those accessibility features available for hearing impaired individuals, whether they're wearing made by iPhone hearing aids or Cochlear devices.
We're big fans of Apple's accessibility features too. There's a lot in there.
A ton.
How do you use the Nucleus Smart App to personalize your device? Because I understand that you can create different environments.
Yep, so within the app, I've got a few different things. One, I can change the program that I'm using with my processor. And the program is really what is set up by you and the audiologist. But there's a feature in there called Scan, which essentially automates my hearing to fit the environment. And then there's another program I have available that it's just a more basic program. There's also a feature called Forward Focus, which allows you to basically cut out the sound behind you so you can focus on the person in front of you in a noisy restaurant, for example. The app allows you to change volume, volume and programs I mentioned, as well as the ability to initiate streaming with your wireless devices. So there's a mini mic wireless device, which is what I call an extendable ear, a TV streamer, where I can hear directly from the TV into my ears. And that's really the bulk of it with the wireless accessories. There's also a hearing tracker, which essentially tracks your time and speech throughout the day. So you can make sure you're hearing as much as you can through the processor. And there's also, haven't had to use it yet, but it is a Find My Processor feature in the event that I lose my Kanso 2 if it ever falls off.
So tell me a little bit about what's that automatic transition like and how has that improved your experience based on the old processors?
Yeah, so with Scan, let's say I'm driving in the car. You guys merge onto the highway, you know it's a noisy world out there. What's nice about Scan is it helps compress that road noise down so I can hear more of what matters, aka my wife sitting in the passenger seat talking to me or even the radio. Scan also makes it easy if I walk into a coffee shop where it's super noisy, it helps bring that noise level down a bit and try to enhance the speech based on who I'm talking to. Cool. So it's really, in a way, and this is not a official cochlear term by any means, but I almost feel like Scan's one step towards mimicking the way people with natural hearing kind of automatically make that adjustment with their hearing to hear their best in the environment.
I know that from personal experience with my parents that the different sound environments, the noisier restaurant environments can be particularly challenging even for people with even moderate hearing loss. It's amazing the amount of processing power that it must take technically for this device to be able to process and do all that stuff in real time.
Absolutely. It's amazing what our engineers can do.
What would you say to someone on the fence right now about getting a cochlear implant or the Kanso 2 sound processor?
For someone deciding on getting a Kanso 2 sound processor, you've never heard anything like it in that it's something truly off the ear, it's truly smart, and it directly integrates with your lifestyle so that you can just get on with the day and focus on living versus focusing on your hearing loss.
We're having a perfectly natural conversation right now, and I would have absolutely no idea that you had any hearing loss at all because it's invisible, and obviously you can understand everything I'm saying perfectly. It's awesome.
Yep. Yeah. And I have to say, I credit my parents, all my teachers growing up, doctors, surgeons, audiologists, but most importantly, the technology.
I just want to thank Greg. Thank you so much for being with us today and for telling us about the Kanso 2 sound processor.
Take care.
Once again, we'd like to thank Greg White for sitting down and talking to us about the Kanso 2 sound processor. You can learn more about this sound processor by clicking the link in the description. It'll take you right to Cochlear's website. Learn everything you need to know. Thank you so much for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed. Leave a comment down below with any thoughts you have. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more great videos.